one of the most important days in orange juice of the year. We are going to get a look at a very, very influential private forecaster named Patty Stiegler. We're going to get a look at what she believes the next year's Florida orange juice crop will look like.
This report has become more and more of a volatile thing over the years.
The market is very jittery. It's going to be very jittery today. It comes out anytime during the trading day. Nobody knows when.
It's really a tight, closed group that determines this, you know, crop report number.
There's a breakfast meeting going on right now. In that meeting, it is sealed doors, no telephones, no nothing. During that meeting, she will release the number, and then all pandemonium will break loose. Everybody will leave it, run out of there, get to the phones. You'll see it impacted here. This is a tough day. I haven't slept in 2 days. This is, we're gonna make millions or lose millions today. It's literally gonna be like that.
I'm going to work, kind of in a bad mood. I worked all weekend at SX, the restaurant. I worked Friday night, Saturday night until late, and then Sunday day. I have a cold, and yeah, it's Monday morning, so that's not helping. I just don't know if I could do it anymore, you know, working like, I mean, if you do the math, it's probably like 70 hours this week that I worked. It's just like, it's a Crimea River.
This is what we're gonna do. You guys are going to explain your one good trade. All of our fundamentals should be covered. All right, so Laetitia, you're up.
I noticed that 120 was a resistance level before and it was like ticking back up to that. So I thought that if it crossed that 120 level, I would get long and it'd probably shoot up, you know, at least 50 cents. I bought 200 shares. I don't think I was fast enough on the keyboard because I only got in around 120.12. I sold 100 shares at 120.67 when I saw that bid start dropping, and then another 100, 2 cents below.
It's okay. I mean, I like that, actually. I like how you hit that when the bid started to drop. You know, you had a bunch of things in your favor, right? You had intraday, you wanted it to be above 120. You had bids tested above 120 and it held. You had the fact that you noticed the pattern that around these whole numbers, the stock was getting real strong. You know, it's much more important to stick with your system than it is to worry about 10 cents and 15 cents and 20 cents. You can't possibly predict the bottom and the tops of all the moves. All right, it's about developing a system. It's not about the results of one trade. I can't wait for you guys actually to show me a trade where you lost money and you told me that was a good trade, because then you're really starting to get it.
This is my 6 week of training. I believe it's the last week too. We're supposed to go live next week. I'm about to start looking for some stocks that I could possibly trade during the day. You know, some stocks that had some earnings report, some sort of news that would make them in play. I'm kind of curious as to how the market's going to open today, because last week was pretty crazy. I mean, everything was down.
Last week, there was a lot of bombs in the credit markets, and the market moved sharply lower. I'm not an economist. I'm not a mutual fund manager. Those things, they're interesting as a backdrop for us, but the reality is that we're not investors, we're traders, and so we couldn't care less if the market goes up or down. We want it to just be moving. The volatility is our friend. That's what allows us to make money.
We're heading to Teterboro Airport to go look at a potential investment opportunity for the fund. I was contacted by a guy who's developing an equestrian ranch out in Connecticut. To my understanding, they've partially done some development and they're looking for some additional financing. I told him I was too busy to take a look, but one of the managers has a private plane. He offered to fly out, grab us, and fly us there and back. So hopefully we can have a quick round trip and see if it's something worth further pursuing. It's very important to go actually meet with local management on their terrain, go look at the property, really get a sense for things. We need to eliminate as many risks as possible.
So this is our parachute right up here. The hits the fan, we pull down and the parachute comes out the back.
I sold you 4 lots. I sold you 5 lots.
Just telling you how I'm playing.
Word has leaked out that was supposed to be a breakfast meeting starting at 8:30 is now starting at 11:30. So we know that everything's been pushed back for about an hour and a half or so.
Last year, I think it happened at around 1 o'clock almost. Yeah. Other years, it's happened 10:30. I've seen every year almost a different time.
Our expectation is somewhere between 155 million and 170 million boxes of juice is what we think is going to be here. Anything in there, we should be okay. Anything outside of that, we're going to have to fight for our lives. Roger, what do you expect the number to be?
Because I asked you that because I know a year ago we were at Yankee Stadium drinking beers. Do you remember that?
Right.
And you nailed it.
I nailed it. I was right on.
Subscribing to you.
I mean, I think 155 is what the industry says will be the number.
What number are you looking for?
Maybe 140, 150, I think it'll be bullish. What do you think?
I think that I think we can get to 125 to 135.
I think it'll be more like around a 147, 140. I think it'll be under 150. I would be surprised if it's over 150.
125 to 135. Above 135, I'm selling.
Today we just wait around and stare at one another and try and figure out what we're going to do. Hence the signs, so we don't waste our breath with people coming over and asking us questions.
Leave me alone.
Go away. That's actually Dave's song. What? Everybody asks, like anybody who does business, you see the signs over there? What? Everyone says, what's the number going to be? So you just put it up to leave us alone, you know, go away.
Leave us alone.
I will tell you that I did wear my famous orange shirt in honor of today. But, you know, if I lose a couple of million, it will be burned.
Coming up next on Wall Street Warriors.
As an investment property, I can't see where this is going to go anywhere but up.
Everybody has their own economic interest to make as much money as they can, and they don't give a f- if they take your money. What is it? What's the number? What is it?
I'll sell you 10 on my watch. And 1,000 with it.
We opened here at 10 o'clock, and it was very, very wild, very hyper trading around the ring and the options as final bets are being made in front of this number.
Everybody's positioned right now. Everybody's waiting.
It's a nerve game. I mean, you look around, you see people are actually a little nervous. You know, there's a lot of money at stake.
People's heads turn purple and, you know, rivers of sweat run down their face.
I mean, I've went through these reports where I went home down $100,000 or $200,000.
People see their IRA evaporating or stuff like that. A lot of human drama here.
People chewing this gum, this caffeine gum, like they need it in there to get them really, get their heart rates really up.
Ten tendons!
The hate index is probably mirroring an all-time high in here because everybody hates everybody in this pit.
Hey! Element to get in the pit, both feet, NFL rules.
Almost on every single trade, there's either a comment made or somebody's nickeling or diming the market.
Stop
ridiculous. Everybody has their own economic interest to make as much money as they can. And personally, they don't give a f- if they take your money. I mean, one minute they'll be your friend and they'll tell you how great you are and how great you look and da-da-da, let's get together. And on the other hand, they're stealing money from your other pocket while you're not looking. Of course I'm doing it, but I try to be, you know, hey, you look good today. And then I pickpocket them. But it's all going on. And I think over time, everybody realizes that everybody's got their hand in everybody's pocket and it's what's going on. Everybody's trying to everybody as much as they can.
One of the core values of our desk is the sharing of information.
It's a really a team environment, you know? Everyone shares their ideas.
Yeah.
Each trader gets to hear other traders' thoughts on the desk as to what stock they believe will be the best stocks to trade for the day. That way we all benefit.
No, it's just the same thing. I mean, it had a big explosive move. If someone, you know, says, oh, I think this stock is going to be in play, and it turns out someone else trades it and loses a lot of money, you can't be mad at that person because they told you to trade that stock. You know, it's your responsibility.
You're only as good as the stocks that you trade. You can be a great trader, but if you can't identify the right stocks to be in, you'll struggle to make money. Right now I'm watching Apple computer, which is down about 2.5 points. That's the type of movement that allows me to make money. You can draw a trend line here. This is trending down. But you can see, as it moved back up, it couldn't reach the previous high, and it pulled back again. 140 can act as a big support level. It's about a point from there right now, so I'm watching it to see if it shows some support. If it does, I'll probably look to get long. As long as there's movement, you can make money.
northeast to clear the class Bravo and squawking 4541.
Okay, what we're going to do is just a quick circle around the horse farm.
As far as looking to invest into the property, there's not a better way to see all the land than to look over top to see what's everything around it, what's the community really like, what are the road accesses like.
This is the whole property right here. You can see the indoor riding facility, which is the largest structure, and the two roads that fork off.
Fantastic. How much land is in total you guys have?
It's 103 acres.
Wow. But do you guys have horses there already?
Yeah, 40 of them.
That's great. And what's the capacity going to be?
It's going to be about 65. We actually have a waiting list right now.
So there's a major demand for that type of service then?
It's a huge demand, and this is one of the few, if not the only, gated equestrian community within a two-hour drive of New York City.
Wow.
6026 kilos checking in 5,500.
Let's see if I remember how to do this. Welcome to Waterbury, Oxford. So this is the beginning of Willow Creek Equestrian Facility. We've gotten approval to build 24 high-end boutique homes.
Pretty out here.
Here and two more lots over here. As an investment property, I can't see where this is going to go anywhere but up.
Damn.
The large tracts of land in Connecticut are rapidly disappearing, especially within a two-hour drive of New York City.
Sure.
You can't get into Greenwich anymore. Driving out to the Hamptons is almost impossible. So this is the indoor riding ring. It's one of the larger indoor facilities in Connecticut. It's great in the winter. The heat tends to stay in the building, so it's good for the horses and it's good for the humans. First home we're building is right over here. It'll have a pool out in the back.
How much money have you guys put into here already?
$7 million. Having an extra couple million bucks will allow us to plow a bunch of money into marketing. We think in this market at this time that it's going to generate a lot higher price per home. The French doors opening out to the back.
That's pretty cool.
And it's a wonderful view.
Different world.
We structure it in a manner that's really not risky.
What's a typical return for a good sub-debt piece for you?
I give up return for risk. I kind of look for a 15 to 25% return in my analysis on businesses. You know, 3 years, usually not beyond a 3-year term.
As far as my hedge fund goes, we launched one of our programs last month. We did about 5.5-6%. We had a tremendous month. We are trading big assets in orange juice, as well as launching in all the other markets. Right now, we're up $149,387, you know, for today, right now, in our open trade equity. So right now, we're having a good day and something more to watch, like a roulette wheel here you watch. But we are, now we're up $150,000. Let's get it on.
So we're getting ready for all hell to break loose in here, you think, though.
Right here now, for the most part, all bets have been made. And it's just a wait-and-see attitude. Everybody's just hanging out waiting. It can come out at any moment, all hell can break loose in here.
I tell you exactly what happens. The phone rings like it's ringing. Somebody gives a number. You'll see a group of traders just start doing something in the market. When you see like the volume increase and the market move pretty quickly, you pretty much know that the number's out.
It's out at 110. 110 is when it's out, just like last year.
Everybody's just waiting and looking and trying to figure out what the number is, and every little movement in the market, everybody feels that the number's out, somebody knows something. And it's every year.
It's coming out.
Comes out anytime. We have a closed door meeting. Anytime when they decide to release a number, it's chaos.
Falling asleep. So much adrenaline is expended waiting for this number that it's, you know.
You wait.
2 minutes.
120 foot.
Oh. 165 feet.
Hey! Wes! What's the number? What is it?
Our expectation is somewhere between 155 million and 170 million boxes of juice is what we think is going to be here. Anything outside of that, we stand to lose a couple million dollars.
The most difficult thing was getting the approvals to do the lots. The second most difficult thing was getting in the roads. We've done that, and this is where the value really comes in, is right now, sure. Which is why we're looking for the equity partner.
And that's when you really need the money now, is to finalize all the
right now.
You know, all the marketing pieces, get into the development and stuff
right
like that, so you can actually start selling off the
exactly.
lots.
Exactly. And banks aren't very good at financing marketing.
Companies, you know, as they're in their launch phase, like you guys are, that part of it would be typical of our fund.
Now, the equestrian facility is a wonderful thing. It makes it unique.
Sure.
And if you have a unique property and a good product, then people will come and buy.
That gives some differentiation, some saleability.
Exactly.
James, thanks again for the time. This
Brett.
Is fantastic. We'll look forward to following up.
It's a pleasure.
So after work today, we're all going out bowling to celebrate the end of training, and we're actually supposed to go live with Real Money next week. Bowling night was great. It was really interesting and fun to see the people you work with in a different type of setting, you know, a lot more relaxed, not behind a computer. We had two teams, the team of rookies and then the senior traders. It was a good time, you know, we bonded. We beat their asses. As much as bowling night was fun, it was definitely bittersweet because, you know, my parents are now living in Paris and they've been insistent on me going out there, giving it a try, seeing what the financial world is like. So I'm seriously thinking about giving Paris a try.
It happens. Sometimes it doesn't work out the right way. In this case, it didn't, but.
No trade for 40.
200 million crop.
For 160.
145.
Total surprise here. It came out of 200 million boxes. Marketplace was looking for 145, 150. We're down the limit. In terms of us, we're hurt. We're going to have to figure it out.
Want
to stick these in? Natural gas is f***ing down. Oh,
this is a blood.
Yeah,
this is brutal. You know, the highest estimate I heard was 180, and that was even laughed at. So this number comes out of 200 million boxes. It's a complete bloodbath for the industry in terms of pricing. And, you know, we're going to just head down and down and down now in here. But I told you, when you put a random variable into a marketplace, f*** can happen. And unfortunately, it happened. We covered too early, so we're kind of behind the eight ball here a little bit now. We're going to have to scrounge around and take a look at our position and see
you know, how we can repair it and figure it out from there. All together, pretty for us. Pretty for us, but we'll be back. We'll come back.
It's happened before, it'll happen again. Thank God we're net way ahead, so it does help.
So I'm out $910,000. Just vanished into thin air. I don't want them knowing. It ended up in somebody else's account, basically. Somebody else's account picked it up.
I am glad I wore this suit today. All right, fire this puppy up.
Give a little cowardly line from the Wizard of Oz.
Well, it's going to be, you know, we're going to be the last. Oh, hold on, I'm going to have to kill somebody. Who did that? There's no volatility. What you need to do is take on, that whole ring will be gone this afternoon. I will kill them all. You're all dead.